The fans are, they make it. It's awesome to meet them. The show's transcended so many levels, so many different types of people. You know what I mean? From firemen to criminals. It's the number one show with the cops, with the criminals, with the military, in the penitentiary. It's like it's a very, very different show. First of all, there's never been a show like this. There's never been a show about this subject, for one. And this subject is a secret society. That's what this subject's about. It ain't like another great show, Rescue Me. I love that show. That show's about firefighters, which is not a secret society. This show is about a secret society. So, for instance, you see fans or even crew members, and they're wearing shirts that have patches on the top and bottom, where in real life, you can't be wearing no patches unless you earn that patch. Because that is some other people's culture. It's their culture, you know what I mean? So I think that that's one thing. The writing of the show was exceptional. We had a really, not only a bunch of seasoned great actors like Mark Brody Jr., Charlie Hunnam, Tommy Flanagan, people who have done hundreds of movies like Kim Coates, Ron Perlman. But the writing was, we had great writers on that show, Regina Carrado, Jim Perry, Jack LaJudas, Charles Murray. We had unbelievable writers that everything you see on any screen, anywhere, starts with the writing. So if the writing is garbage, it's not getting anywhere. You know what I mean? And this show really, it transcended all levels, like with the language that it spoke, the language of the street. That was a big thing right there, like just to know the slang of the street and... Yeah, that was one of the big things, the writing, the characters on it. We're all really friends, me, Charlie, Tommy Boone, Kim and Ron and Theo, and like, we're all really, really, really friends in real life. That's like, why was The Sopranos great? It was Italians playing Italians. It was great. So here you got a bunch of people who was playing a show basically about being friends, about being loyal, and they actually are friends and totally loyal. So I think that that transcended to the screen, and I think that people could see that, you know, like, wow, these guys are actually having fun, and it's actually a great show. So I'm the technical advisor on this show. I am the longest human being involved with the show. I'm 5 networks involved before FX got it in their hands. So, authentically, it's not very realistic to think that guys are going to wear their patch and roll in and kill 16 people in an apartment and then get on their bikes and roll down to the bar and there's no 52 LA cops waiting for them. So that's not very authentic. You know what I mean? It's just like, it's made to entertain. There was the Sons of Anarchy blog, and on that blog is... 2 blogs on the website. There's Community and Fat Bob's blog. I'm Fat Bob. I wrote that for 7 years. Well, Fat Bob, you know, Kurt gave me quite a chance. Look where it's steamrolled into. And, you know, I started to write good about the show. And Kurt was like, no, you have to write real about the show. And I said, yeah, well, there's nothing real about the show. And he goes, well, then you have to write that. Or else no one's going to believe your guy that you've created. You know what I mean? It's like, for sure, there are bike clubs, and there's good and bad apples in everything. In every school, in every police department, in every motorcycle club, in every everywhere. There's good and bad guys. Well, this show's made to entertain, and nobody wants to watch good guys. Watching good guys is not very entertaining, believe it or not, to the network. The network wants to see turmoil and craziness and what one man... like Charlie, what his life, how it impacted all these other lives, and how a lot of them went down the drain. You had character arcs of a guy who came on the show, he knows right away he's coming on for 3 episodes or 5 episodes. And then you got a character arc of, like, for instance, somebody like Boone, who is one of my favorite characters. My favorite character was Nero. So Nero had, like, he rolled in, I think, an episode in season 3 or 4 or 5 even. Yeah, late in the thing. Nero was my favorite character. His arc was, it was very real, and his character was full of integrity. You know what I mean? So like a short character arc, a funny character arc, was Tom Arnold. It was funny. He knew he was there for like two episodes. He had a funny little thing. He is Tom Arnold. But I think that we touched on a lot of crazy things. Like, I don't know if you here were aware of, like in my country, everyone's got a gun and all these kids are killing each other. And I don't know if you remember, there was in the beginning of, I believe it's episode 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the kid kills everyone in the school. And that had just happened at the end of season 4 in real life. So that there was a, I think it's a pretty special thing to be able to attack right now topics in the world. You know what I mean? I thought that there was a crazy character arc, that little kid and his little journey. He's like, I don't even know who it was, some little actor. You know, he finds a gun and he goes and does that thing. And that was everything that made some people leave the show. Opie was the most impactful death of the show, because like on the show, and if you know the lore of the show, Jackson and Opie were the best of friends and they grew up together and they did this whole thing together, and how Opie died like a man was like a big deal. I think to the audience that was the most impactful death on the show. But to me personally, to lose my buddy Boone that I had already worked with for 7 years was the most traumatic part of it. If you remember the scene, I'm like crying bullets in that scene. It was like, sometimes it's hard to cry and sometimes it's easy to cry. That day was really, 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 really easy to cry, because like when you say goodbye to somebody, that's a big deal. When like, you know, you now went to work every day with this guy and ate food with this guy and laughed with this guy, and tomorrow he's not going to be there no more. That was hard. There would be nothing without you. Thank you so much for your incredible support. I know me and all my mates on the show appreciate it. It's thank you, thank you, thank you from the bottom of my heart. Really, there'd be no show without you. And watch out for my new show, Street Level. It's coming. Street Level is, you know what, I used it for film school for 7 years. So 3 days after the show, I wrote my own film. I found my friends to be in it. I found the money to do it. And I directed it. I acted in it. There's 24 stars in my first film. And now that show, I ended up writing a series Bible for that show. And I believe that this year, that show is going to go into pre-production. And in the new year, we are going to shoot that show. It's called Street Level. Drea DiMatteo's in it. Mark Boone Jr., Danny Trejo, Robert Patrick, Emilio Rivera, Louis Moncada from Breaking Bad, Theodis Crane from The Walking Dead, myself, Charisma Carpenter's in it, she's in it,